So another, I think, important question for a lot of, you know, the people still in school, what is, like, how do you break in as a director, writer, producer? I know there are a lot of different paths that people take to get there, but what would you say are, like, the most mainstream paths that, or the easiest paths to take to get to that point?
I think we should go.
You don't have to go in order.
You know, I have, from the moment, I got lucky enough to be like a playwright in residence at the Royal Court, and there was a bunch of writers there, and they would set up these collectives and these writers groups. And when I came back to New York, I set up a bunch of these writers groups. And in a weird way, I don't know, like the business works so much on like creating these like circles, concentric circles of exclusivity that you keep feeling like you have to penetrate to get closer and closer to something. And then every time you get there, there's like another circle they won't let you in. So it's a little bit like, let's have our own circle. I had a writer's group for 10 years. I've been in other writer's groups. It was like a cliquish of 6, 7, 8 people working together. And at some point, like, you helped each other out. And even we moved to LA together. And then at some point, we started presenting our work to people just on readings or, you know, like even living room readings. And like a little bit buzz got around. And next thing you know, a couple of assistant agents showed up or producers. And stuff started happening. I mean, You Can Count on Me came out of the writer's group. Like, it was a script that was developed in this writer's group, and then people got turned on by it. So I don't know, it was a way to just, at some point, someone has to hear what you're doing for you to get that connection you need to get into the professional, let's say the first circle of this, that business.
I would say the easiest way to become a director is really simple. Call yourself a director. I literally, that's like anything in life. You want to be that, you got to be it first. You got to believe yourself that that's who you are, and then present yourself as a director. And that's really, really as easy as it is. I can tell you from my experience, so when I first started making this, going back to Assault in the Ring, I was going to be the executive producer, and I hired someone that was going to direct the film. And so what happened was I went to one shoot, the first shoot, he was there, and he's doing an interview with somebody that I had set up. And I was like, well, ask him this, ask him that, ask him this. And by the end of it, I was basically, kind of like on over him asking questions, which had to be the most annoying thing in the world for him. In fact, if that ever happened to me again, I'd probably strangle me. But anyway, and then afterwards, and then he couldn't make it, and he was, he wasn't passionate about it. And I was like, you know what? Let's sever this relationship. I actually paid him what I agreed to, the full amount. And I said, I'm going to be the director of this. And I took it back. And at that moment, I knew that that was right, because it was my film, it was my story. And I got some great advice from a really prolific producer named Eisen Robbins. You guys, if you know the independent world, you might have heard his name. He's produced a lot of independent films. And he's like, never give up the director credit. And I was like, oh, yeah, well, that's fine. Well, now that I have, he goes, never give up the director credit. So going along the way, I'm making Assault in the Ring. I get to HBO. It was HBO Sports. And back before I sold this, they didn't have director credit for their documentaries at HBO Sports. In fact, they did all of their documentaries in-house, executive produced by, it was Ross Greenberg at the time, and Rick Bernstein, and then it was producer, and this a writer, but there was no director for the documentaries. And so they didn't want to give me director, and I said, no way. I want director. And that's when that fight started happening. And I kept my, look, they offered me not a lot of money at first. And I was just like, so scared. I was like, okay, it was a terrible negotiation, but that's usually the way it is for your first film. But I held on to that director's credit. And that's one of the best things that I've done, because, then I'm a director. you know? And, you know, at first I say I'm a director, and then I might get my credit as a director, and then, you know, and then now on HBO sports documentaries, on ESPN films, 30 for 30s, everybody, there's director, director, director. But it wasn't so common back then. I mean, this was only 2009, too. So my advice is, you want to be a director, call yourself a director, and that's who you are. And don't give up that credit, no matter who tries to take it away from you.
One thing I'd say is there is, right now, particularly in New York, there's a lot of work. There's a lot of production work, and there's a lot of post-production work. So this isn't so much directly being a director or writer, but if it's like a very attainable profession right now. And so like anyone who wants to, you know, there's a lot of PA positions available that you can just like find online or by, you know, like Mandy, whatever. I think once you kind of get an internship or get a PA position, there is a lot of work. And like I have a lot of friends now who, you know, you're kind of like, oh, I guess it seems sort of overly ambitious to try to work in the movie business or whatever, but it's like kind of not, at least for the below the line crew stuff, that if you kind of get one PA position, then maybe you have to have like one or two more PA positions. And then, you know, at that point you've been around, you can kind of have a sense of if you're interested in the camera department or if you're interested in post-production. And it is actually very possible, particularly right now, because there's this big tax rebate in New York State. So there's like tons of production and post happening, that it's a real thing you can do. And even though my like eventual aspirations is to write and direct, I love the feeling now of having like a kind of comfy below the line crew training, and that there's like, I have like a skill, you know, I can sound edit and I can edit and I have my little thing I can do. And you know, you meet people who work in the film industry through doing that, and it's like a job. And then it's like, you don't have to have a day job while you're directing. You can, I mean, it's hard, it's, the hours are really bad sometimes and you know, all that. But I'd say that it is really like, everyone I know at this point who's like made a serious concerted effort to work in film is working in film and doing well, because there's a lot of open opportunities.
I agree with all this. I obviously kind of only come from it as like a filmmaker. I haven't tried to work, you know, as an assistant editor or something like that. But that sounds very true, what you're saying. But I agree that the only thing that you need to do in order to be a director is consistently make films, and you have to finish the films. There are so many talented people that I know that who are making things, making shorts, and they just don't get finished and they fizzle out, and it's like they get concerned about something that isn't perfect about it, and they just let it sit and it just ends up not being done. And then, you know, if it is done, it could play at a film festival, you could show it to someone. I mean, that just builds upon the work that you can do. And it's entirely, from my perspective, about your own initiative, at least if you're trying to be a film director or film writer or both or whatever. You have to push your, no one else is going to tell you to write every day. No one else is going to tell you to, you know, spend absurd amounts of money to make short films that are really just practice. But they're all these things are very necessary. Yeah.
Yeah, I totally agree with finishing things. We're saying it a lot, but especially with scripts, it's kind of very easy to, you know, it's not easy to write a script, but it's kind of easy to write a script. You show it to somebody, doesn't work for them, and you're just like, oh, whatever, I'll just, you know, whatever, I'll just put it aside and just write another. No, just like rewrite it, I guess. Like, and like, we like spend so much time rewriting, and many times, like, most of the scripts that we write are not gonna get made, but like, I guess you get, you know, all the professors say that to us, and I guess you hear that a lot, but writing is rewriting. The sense is like, maybe it needs another draft, like, you know, keep going. But something that I think is also very important, or at least has been very important for me, and all the jobs that I have gotten so far, well, now I got one that's not because of that, but all the jobs are because of my friends, or the people that before the MFA, I helped just because I wanted to help them, because they were my friends and I was having fun with them on set and I loved them and I loved what they were doing and I wanted to try to help them in what they were doing. Then when I was doing my short, they all came and helped me and didn't sleep for 4 days because they were helping me. You really need those people. I feel like I would feel really lonely if I didn't have those people, and I really wouldn't know how to. And in a very organic way, you know, some of my friends now are producers in Spain, and they want to help me produce my, you know, maybe my next film, let's hope, or something. Or even with my friends here, you know, now I have a friend who's a producer working this company, and now she gives us work as, you know, as readers or as, you know. If you're generous with other people, then it comes back to you, and film is such a collaborative art. Like you need other people. That's like, so if you find a group of people that you get along with and that you share, you know, the same taste, and then you can watch films together and break them down, and you know, I think that's really important. At least to not feel alone at the beginning, because I think it's very, the way I saw it when I came out of undergrad, I was like, whoa, this is, it looked impossible. I was like, this huge business, and what am I gonna do? You know, I'm all alone. And then I started meeting all these people, and I was like, oh, you know what, it's not that hard. I'm just gonna go work with this person, and then this, and then that. And it's so much easier. Like, that for me is super important.
I think there's a little bit of, like, there's a myth about the business a little bit that you kind of get anointed or, like, you win a lottery ticket or something. And luck is definitely part of it. Like, sometimes you're in the right place at the right time, but you kind of generate the opportunity to be in the right place at the right time. And the idea of finishing drafts or, like you said, like, just do another draft of something that maybe someone doesn't like. I mean, I just did a pilot for Warp Films. They're, like, a London-based company, and kind of connected with ITV, and we did 27 drafts. I mean, it came out really good. Like, I think it's really good, but it was 27 drafts later when it was really good. Like, I don't know. I mean, you could stop after 3 drafts, I guess, but there's just, like, a certain amount of it is just work, you know?
And I think also if you're gonna make something, if you want to direct something, really take the time to make sure you're happy with the script before directing it. Like, in any kind of short feature, whatever. I've definitely had experiences where I've made little shorts and then realized, like, well, I learned some stuff for it, but I probably should have, like, had a better sense of what the ending was going to be before starting it, you know. And that, and I was telling Jason that I'm working now as an assistant on this, like, big studio movie, and the script, you know, we've now shot the movie that was based on the script. And it's, you know, it's good. The performances are good. It's a good version of the script. And now the producers are having all these problems with these story points that are exactly the same as what were in the script, you know? So it's this, like, weird, confusing thing of, like, well, this problem was there in the script first, you know? And there's like, that cliche line of, like, you can't make a good movie from a bad script. And I feel like that is true. This has been a very interesting experience of seeing, like, on a big scale, the exact same thing happen as, you know, has happened to, like, me and all my friends on their own little tiny things.
I also wanted to say that, you know, there hasn't been a single project that I've worked on,
and now I've worked on a lot, that there was a moment where I was like, this is crap. I mean, nobody's gonna watch this. They're never gonna sign off on this. Every single project I've worked on, I wanted to, like, just, like, hide under my desk and just be like, it's over. And you know, that is the defining moment if you wanna be in this business or be successful in any business, is to just keep moving forward, you know, and just say, okay, well, what can I do? Just like it was said, you know, just gotta keep working. You know, this is not, never gonna make something, you know, if you're lazy. You're never gonna make something if you quit, you know, and there's gonna be times, there were times for me where I did not believe in what I was doing, because all of a sudden these voices came into my head that said, nobody's gonna like this, what's the point, this and that. And my only advice to that is to, like, talk to your friends, you know, get people to watch what you're, you know, at all stages of what you're doing, you know, get a lot of feedback. I ask people for opinions. We have interns, I get them in the edit room, I get everybody, I wanna hear everybody. Doesn't mean I'm gonna listen to it, but I want as much, you know, input and opinions. I wanna hear what people think. You never know. know what will come out of, you know, the person that you wouldn't expect it. I once showed something to the guy that was delivering for FedEx. You know, I was like, can you just come here? Oh, you like this? Can you come, you know, this sport? You know, can you watch this? And I got some valuable feedback. So be open to that and know that, you know, I don't know about writing a script, but I do know about making, you know, a film, you know, that there's always a moment where you're like, this is the horrible. So, you know, if you can get through that, usually you can get to a better place.
It's interesting about, you know, if you get notes that you completely don't agree with, they usually have some kind of instructive thing about them where you can recognize how to approach something slightly differently to make someone who has that thinking understand the the project more or whatever. It's all valuable, everything that you can, all the feedback you can get.